Have you been able to get the beverage machine to work yet?
Water in Half-Life has a distinct look to it, a kind of wavy, stretchy, jelly-like movement. It's definitely an upgrade from other games just using flat textures, but it does look a bit strange in some places. Of course, we don't have to nitpick, these are graphics from the 90s, but what if I told you this is what the water used to look like before it was changed? When looking at the settings of Half-Life, you get the option between OpenGL rendering and software rendering. Software rendering was the state the game was first developed in, but the power of 3D acceleration gives Half-Life the look most people recognize today, with features like actual widescreen, smoother models, and smoother textures. Either due to technical limitations or a stylistic decision, the game's liquid graphics changed from this rippling, shimmering effect to a busier sort of squashing and stretching. A consequence of this change is that the water textures, meant more as reflections that have effects placed on them, become a representation of the water itself. In bodies of water, it looks okay, but then you get into situations like a clogged sink, or a puddle, and it doesn't look as natural as it did before. This effect is also used for toxic waste, and the murky red-brown water in Zen. It kinda looks nice for toxic goop in my opinion, but the Zen water is a weird case. The original texture seems to either have a rocky surface underneath it or a sort of bubbling pattern. Here, these stones or bubbles become part of the water. Maybe that just makes it look more alien. Evidence of maps being designed with software rendering in mind first can be seen in the deathmatch map Bounce, where a normal little sewer area has a graphical glitch when rendered with OpenGL. At the same time, this shows a feature of the new water I failed to mention. Along with the change in how the texture is modified, water is given a wave effect that animates in 3D. Specifically, this water effect in maps is customizable, so the size of the waves can be made small, large, or completely flattened. Both 2D and 3D waves can be seen in Half-Life, and Gearbox's expansions take advantage of this customizable value to make some of the waves, well, wavier. In software rendering, these details are lost, meaning OpenGL's water was not an afterthought. Something worth noting is that the new water effect's stretching is actually based on the water in Quake. Knowing Quake's engine was heavily modified to create Half-Life's GoldSrc engine, that makes the updated visuals using some legacy programming even more interesting to me. To add on to that, when you go underwater in Quake, there's a wavy distortion effect put over the screen to make it harder to see. As a detail only visible in software rendering mode, Half-Life pixelates the screen when underwater to create a similar effect. Depending on the renderer, the water is Quake-like in different ways. This change isn't game-breaking by any means, and I'm glad for the 3D waves effect and how they can be used by mappers, but the texture-based wave animation is an impressive detail that was lost to time. However, at least one modder has experimented with a best-of-both-worlds approach for OpenGL that re-implements some of that dynamic texture action onto the 3D waves. As an interesting tidbit, this means Half-Life Source's water could actually be a little closer to the original artistic intent. Or not. Maybe that's a bit of a stretch.